Okay, we have a piece of 2x2x8" by 10" aluminum L stock angle iron, if it was iron. SO239x3/8" 24 stud mount, a U clamp, two pieces of 5/16" by 19¼ approximately aluminum rod pressed into 3/8" 24 inch mounts. This one has a nut on the end, which is going to be the ground side. The other one's going to go into the mount like that. Let me get some holes started, some holes drilled, and I'll report back and show you the 2 meter half wave dipole. Okay, we have the 1/2 inch hole for the mount, a little over 3/8 inch for the ground radio, which is going to go down. The mount's going to come up. Now I just need to mark, measure, drill one sort of bracket. I'm also going to put a 1/4 inch hole on this side. That way with a 1/4x20 nut, you could use this on a tripod. This is going to be a portable dipole, so that's my intention. So let me do some more measure, marking, and drilling. I'll be right back. For all the drilling, I'm using a unibit. I don't know if you ever seen a unibit, stip bit. Just basically starts off small, goes in one diameter. I have a 3-pack of them, different diameters. These are the easiest way to keep a nice straight hole when you're fabricating something. Okay, got these holes here marked. I'm going to drill these out. And up here, I'm going to measure this so it's directly between the U-bolt that come out this way. Going to be slightly a 5/16 inch hole, so you can put this on top of a 1/4x20 tripod mount or a light stand mount and use it that way. This antenna is for portable, so what I need to figure out is, you know, how far away from the edge do I need to be, how large of a diameter is my light stand so I have clearance, etc., etc., etc. Okay, so we have the mount mounted. The ground side going down, the 1/4 inch 5/16 vertical coming up, the ground going down, the bracket here, which just basically attaches like that through there. And what do I need to do? Oh yes, I need to drill the hole. I need to get out the light stand measure mark. I think the light stand is 1 inch in diameter, so if I stay 3/4 inch away from this edge, in between these loops here, but give myself a 5/16 inch hole, that gives enough room this way for the light stand to clear, but still function, and I can use it on a light stand or some kind of improvised mast for field day or portable operations, you know, the races, public service events, something like that. And being the rod is 5/16 inch in diameter, I would imagine this thing would have some incredible bandwidth. Anyways, let me finish up the last hole and see if I can get it mounted on a piece of tubing outside real quick to show you what it should look like in free space. Okay, for the light stand mount hole, I've came over 3/4 inch and down. I think it was 3/4 inch. Anyways, that puts me in perfect alignment between the bracket, so if I want to leave that on there but leave it attached so I don't lose the nuts and bolts, I can use the light stand mount as well. So let me get a little 5/16 inch hole drilled there, and then we'll get it mounted outside as promised. So anyways, I went back, added some lock washers to the upright vertical and the ground part, so was locked in. Aluminum has a tendency to, once you compress it, to shrink a little set. You know, I torqued it probably, I don't know, hand tightness, 25, 35 foot-pounds. It's enough for this purpose. Okay, so after looking at one of my light stands, noticing each one was a little bit different. The bigger ones were larger. I think it was 3/8. So I enlarged this hole to 3/8. That'll give us enough to work with anything that I have for mounting capability. So you have the clamp, tripod, light stand mount, so you get a little versatility here. Let me get this mounted outdoors and show you how it looks. I made a faux pas. Antenna mount that I have in the backyard is 1.5 inches diameter. This is 1¼. so it fits over 1-inch pipe. Couldn't remember why I bought the same clamp as I did before, because that's the light stand. The other portable mount I have takes a 1-inch diameter tubing, so can't show you it mounted, but basically here it is. This is going to mount over the tube, the mast, and then the dipole is just going to mount like this in free space, so probably be the same distance away from a tripod mast mount, something like this. So this is for portable operation. Mount this thing, and it'll just give me a way to, you know, plug the HT into it, the coax, run down the mast. I know an HT extends my range, something like that. A little packet antenna, all-star node portable antenna, something like that. So that's it. Sorry I don't have the mast to show you it mounted as promised. Go build your own. 7-3. It's easy as pie. Hi, hi.